Exotic weapons range. Item tiny. Book me, Barry. One. Cost one gold piece. Damage one. Crit times two. Range increment 5 feet. Weight 110 pounds. Type two pierce. Item tiny. Skip rock halfling. Cost 3 gold pieces. Damage 1.3. Crit times two. Range increment 10 feet. Weight 1/4 of a pound. Okay, and Bikini Marie is 1/10 of a pound. And Skip Rock Halfling is 1/4 of a pound. Next type 2 bludgeoning. Item, small mollusk 2-ball 1. Cost 5 gold pieces. Damage 1.4. Crit times 2. Range increment 10 feet. Weight 2 pounds. Type 2 bludgeon. Item, small calculus gnome. Cost 15 gold pieces. Damage slash. Critical slash. Range increments 50 feet. Weight 2 pounds. Type 2 special 1. Item, small chakram. Cost 15 gold pieces. Damage 1.4. Crit times 3. Range increment 30 foot. Weight 2 pounds. Type 2 slashy. Item, throwing iron. Cost 8 gold pieces. Damage 1.6. Crit 19 through 20 times 2. Range 6 increment 15 foot 1. Weight 3 pounds. Type 2 slash. Item, medium size gauntlet, spring loaded. Cost 200 gold pieces. Damage 1.4. Crit times 2. Range increment 20 feet. Weight 4 pounds. Type 2 piercing. Item, javelin spinning 1. Cost 2 gold pieces. Damage 1.8. Crit 19 through 20 times 2. Range increment 50 foot. Weight 2 pounds. Type 2 piercing. Item, large crossbow break 1. Cost 100 gold pieces. Damage 1.12. Crit 19 through 20 times 2. Range increment 150 feet. Weight 15 pounds. Type 2 piercing. Item, large double bow elven 1. Cost 1,000 gold pieces. Damage 1.8. Crit times 3. Range increment 90 feet. Weight 3 pounds. Type 2 piercing. Item, large harpoon. Cost 15 gold pieces. Damage 1.10. Crit times 2. Range increment 30 feet. Weight 10 pounds. Type 2 piercing. Item, large Long bow can be used as a normal long bow, efficiency, Elvin Doublebug can use the bow to fire two arrows at once, knocking an arrow on the second string requires a move equivalent action. Once the wielder has taken an action to load the second string, his next attack is a double shot that launches both arrows simultaneously at the same time, targeting. The wielder makes one attack roll at a negative 2 penalty to determine whether or not both arrows strike the target. If the attack is successful, both arrows deal normal damage. If the attack is a critical hit, only one arrow deals extra damage, and extra sneak attack damage is applied only once. Duan. The Duan is a long spear with a standard spearhead as well as two blades curved so that they point backwards along the shaft. The weapon has reach, allowing you to strike opponents 10 feet away with it. Those proficient with the Duan can also attack adjacent foes with the reverse heads using a practice reverse thrust. Apply a negative 2 penalty on the attack roll if you use the Duan to attack a second adjacent opponent in the same round that you attack the first opponent. Bakini Bari Mouth darts. These slim, almost needle-like metal darts are concealed in the mouth, then spit at the target. Their effective range is extremely short and they deal little damage, but they are highly useful when taking an opponent by surprise. You can fire up to 3 Bakini Bari per attack, all at the same target. Do not apply your strength modifier to damage with Bakini Bari. They are too small to carry the extra force that a strong character usually imparts to a thrown weapon. The cost and weight for a single Bakini Bari. Full blade. A full blade is 18 inches longer than a greatsword and is too large for a medium-sized creature to use with two hands without special training. Thus, it is an exotic weapon. Medium-sized creatures cannot use a full blade one-handed at all. A large creature could use the full blade with one hand, but it would be assessed the standard -4 non-proficiency penalty on its attack rolls. Large creatures can use the full blade in two hands as a martial weapon. A large creature with the exotic weapon's proficiency, full blade, feet, can use the full blade in one hand, but a medium-sized creature must use both hands, even if it has the relevant feet. A full blade is also called an ogre's greatsword. Gauntlet Spring Loaded. This gauntlet possesses a broad range of metal that extends along the bottom of the forearm to the edge of the wrist. Articulation for a circular orifice is visible. This ridge of metal hides a spring-loaded mechanism that can expand fell and fought with great force, akin to a minuscule crossbow. He loved the gauntlet, laying certain folk in the hole and pulling back a hidden lever, loading gauntlet is a move equivalent action that provokes an attack of opportunity. You fire the spring-loaded gauntlet by setting down your arm, then flip your hand back so that your palm faces your opponent. This motion fires the gauntlet. The cost and weight are for a single gauntlet. A character who attempts to fire two spring-loaded gauntlets at once incurs the standard penalty for two-weapon fighting. The dexterity feat lets someone avoid the -4 offhand penalty. Great sword material. This huge blade hides a secret reservoir of quicksilver, also called mercury by the alchemists, that runs along the interior blade in a slender channel. When the blade is vertical, the mercury swiftly fills an interior bulb in the haft, but when swung, the heavy liquid flows out into the blade, making it heavier. In non-proficient hands, this shifting mass penalizes the welder by an additional -3 penalty on attack rolls, beyond the normal -4 non-proficiency penalty for using an exotic weapon untrained. A dire spike. A dire spike is a double weapon. A stout shaft holds a flail on one end and a long sword on the other. You can fight with it as if fighting with two weapons. But if you do, you incur all the normal attack penalties for two-weapon fighting, as if you were using a one-handed weapon and a light weapon. You get a +2 bonus on your opposed attack roll when attempting to disarm an enemy when you wield a dire spike, including the opposed attack roll to avoid being disarmed yourself if you fail to disarm your enemy. You can also use this weapon to make trip attacks if you are tripped during your own trip attempt. You can drop the dire spike to avoid being tripped. Harpoon. The harpoon is a broad-bladed spear forged with barbs and shaft of the harpoon. And the shaft of the harpoon has a trailed rope attached to a control harpoon. Components. The shaft of the harpoon has a trailing rope attached to control harpoon components. Though designed for hunting whales and other large sea creatures, the harpoon can be used on dry land. Even with the exotic weapon's proficiency, harpoon feet, creatures smaller than medium size take a -2 penalty on their attack rolls due to their harpoon's weight and bulk. If it deals damage, the harpoon lodges in an opponent who who fell to a left saving throw against a DC equal to 10 plus the damage dealt. The harpoon creature moves at only half speed and cannot charge or run. If you control the trailing rope by succeeding at an opposed strength check when holding it, an harpoon creature can move only within the limits that the rope allows. The trailing rope is 30 feet long. If the harpoon creature attempts to cast a spell, it must succeed on a concentration check, DC 15, or fail losing the spell. The harpoon creature can pull the harpoon from its wound if it has two free hands and it takes a full round action to do so. But it deals damage to itself equal to the initial damage the harpoon dealt. For example, if you hit with a harpoon and deal 8 points of damage, the target takes another 8 points of damage when it removes the harpoon. The character who succeeds on a heal check, DC 15, can remove a harpoon without further damage. Javelin spinning. This light, flexible spear intended for ranged attacks resembles a standard javelin except for the spiral grooves that run down its length. You can loop a throwing spring around the shaft. The other end is tied to your finger. The string imparts spin to the javelin upon release, improving the weapon's accuracy, range, and penetrating power by permitting a harder cast. Looping a string around the javelin is a move equivalent action that provokes an attack of opportunity. Tying a casting string around your finger is a full round action that provokes an attack of opportunity by the same string, but the same string is reused for multiple javelins. The javelin can be thrown without spinning, in which case its damage range and threat range are those of a standard javelin. If used in melee, treat the spin javelin as a standard javelin. Kopesh. You can use a Kopesh to make a trip action within its hook-like blade. If you are tripped during your own trip attempt, you can drop the Kopesh to avoid being tripped. Longsword Mercurial. As the Mercurial Greatsword, except that in a non-proficient hand, the shifting mass and fill of the blade penalizes the wielder by an additional -2 penalty on attack rolls, beyond the normal -4 non-proficient penalty for using an exotic weapon untrained. Lucerne Handle. This polearm resembles a pick on a pole and is designed to puncture heavy armor. Mace Double. A stout shaft with a spiked cylindrical head at each end. This is a double weapon. You can fight with it as if fighting with two weapons, but if you do, you incur all the normal attack penalties associated with fighting with two weapons as if you are using a one-handed weapon and a live weapon. See Attacking with Two Weapons, Chapter 8 of the Player's Handbook. A creature wielding a double weapon in one hand can't use it as a double weapon. Manthi. A manthi is a short spear with four additional spear heads that project vertically from the shaft, creating a star pattern of five blade heads instead of just a single forward pointing blade. The advantage of the unusual blade arrangement is that you can make an additional attack of opportunity during the round. The maul is simply a two-handed warhammer of enormous size, dwarves' favorite. Panther Claw. The Panther Claw looks much like a punch dagger with two extra blades. The blades retain the punch dagger's deadly force, and the extra blades are useful for disarming opponents. Wielder's proficiency with the Panther Claw gain a plus two circumstance bonus when making disarm attempts with it. Scythe. A scythe, prong-like extrusions are designed to help catch and disarm opponent's weapons. If you attempt to disarm your opponent using a scythe, you gain a plus 4 bonus on the opposed attack roll. You don't gain any bonus if someone tries to disarm you of your scythe. A monk using a scythe can strike with her unarmed base attack bonus, including her more favorable attacks per round, along with other applicable modifiers. Sephara. The ancient sword is a smaller version of the Kapesh. You can use the Sephara to make trip attacks with its hook-like blade. If you are tripped during your own trip attempt, you can drop the Sephara to avoid being tripped. Scimitar Double. The carved blades of the double scimitar are used most effectively when spinning and twirling with the weapon. Despite its size, the weapon benefits more from quick, precise movement than from brute force. The double scimitar is a double weapon. You can fight with it as if fighting with two weapons, but if you do, you incur all the normal attack penalties associated with fighting with it. Two weapons as if you are using a one-handed weapon and a light weapon. See attacking with two-handed weapons in Chapter 8 of the Player Handbook. The creature using a double weapon in one hand can't use it as a double weapon. Chocolate Fork. Special training turns a grapefruit-sized spear of crude iron into a deadly projectile. Even with the exotic weapon proficiency, Fork Chocolate Feet, a wielder must be medium size or larger to use the weapon effectively, or take an additional -3 penalty on attack rolls, in addition to the standard -4 non-proficiency penalty. Skiprock Halfling. These polished, perfectly weighed stones are prized by halflings for it. If thrown well enough, they ricochet off one target to strike a second. If the skiprock hits its target, it ricochets towards another target of the Brothers' choice, as you sent to the original target within 5 feet. The thrower immediately makes a second attack roll for the skip rock against the new target, with an attack bonus equal to the first roll, -2. Skip rocks could be used as sling bullets, but using a skip rock ricochet ability in conjunction with a sling requires taking an exotic weapon proficiency feat specifically for that purpose. Stump knife. A stump knife is akin to a punching dagger, except that it can be securely attached to the stump of a missing forelimb. For someone's proficient in its use, the stump knife becomes an extension of his body. Against those to whom you have dealt damage during a continuous melee, the stump knife's threat range is doubled, 17 through 20. Your opponent cannot disarm you of a stump knife. Sword butterfly. A monk using a sword butterfly fights with her unarmed base attack bonus, including her favorable number of attacks per round, along with other applicable modifiers. 3-section staff. Originally a farm implement for threshing grain, this weapon is composed of 3 sections of wood of equal length, joined at the end by chain leather or rope. The monk using a 3-section staff, for which she must take an exotic weapon's proficiency feat, fights with her unarmed base attack bonus and her more favorable number of attacks per round, along with other applicable attack modifiers. The 3-section staff requires 2 hands to use. Throwing iron. These weapons have complex blades with 2 or more edges or pointed protrusions. Unlike most curled weapons, throwing irons as often thrown along a horizontal plane as along a vertical one. Tiger claws, also known as bob knock. This is a strap or glove fitted with spikes in the palm and wielded like brass knuckles. Your opponent cannot use a disarm action to disarm you of tiger claws. An attack with tiger claws is considered an armed attack. A monk using tiger claws can strike with her unarmed base attack bonus, including her more favorable number of attacks per round, along with other applicable modifiers. The cost and weight are for a single tiger claw. A slightly different version of Nikud is both a weapon and a climbing tool. Using a pair of Nikuds while climbing grants a +1 circumstance bonus on the climb checks. This bonus does not stack with the +2 bonus from using a climber's kit, because they're essentially the same circumstance. Tantra. A monk using a tantra can strike with her unarmed base attack bonus, including her more favorable number of attacks per round, along with other applicable modifiers. Triple Dagger. This weapon is used in the offhand as a means to disarm an opponent. You hold it as you would a shield, not another weapon, and so do not take penalties for fighting with two weapons. When using a triple dagger, you get a plus 3 circumstance bonus on your opposed attack roll when attempting to disarm an opponent, including the roll to keep from being disarmed if you fail to disarm your opponent. The triple dagger could also be used as a normal dagger if desired, but if used in the offhand, all normal penalties for fighting with two weapons apply. Warfang. This weapon appears to be the untrained eye as nothing more than a beautiful crafted lace fan. In fact, the veins of the fan are crafted with steel, and the tips are needle sharp. When first entering melee using a war fan, you may attempt to bluff check against an opponent's sense motive check. If you win the contest, you gain a plus 4 bonus on attacks made against that foe during the first round of combat. Board Cestus. This is a stout leather gauntlet with a well-forged metal weight sewn into it over the knuckles. A strike with a ward Cestus considered an unarmed attack. If you take a total defense action, you gain an additional plus 1 bonus to your armor class, representing blows you block with the back of your protected hand. Your opponent cannot disarm you of a ward Cestus. Cost and weight are for a single ward Cestus. Whip Mighty. A character who takes the exotic weapon proficiency, Whip, E, is also proficient in the Mighty Whip. The Mighty Whip is made with especially heavy metal that allows a strong wielder to take advantage of an above-average strength score. The Mighty Whip allows you to add your strength bonus to its subdual damage, up to the maximum bonus indicated. Whip Dagger, again, Whip Dagger Mighty. A character who takes the exotic weapon's proficiency, Whip Feet, is also proficient in the Whip Daggers. Unlike standard whips, the Whip Dagger's ability to deal damage is unhindered by armor bonuses and natural armor bonuses, although you keep it in the hand. The Whip Dagger is treated as a ranged weapon with a maximum range of 15 feet and no range penalties. Because the Whip Dagger can wrap around an enemy's leg or other limb, you can make trip attacks with it. If you are tripped during your own trip attempt, you can drop the Whip Dagger to avoid being tripped. You get a plus 2 bonus on your opposed attack roll when attempting to disarm an opponent, including the roll to keep from being disarmed yourself. If you fail to disarm your opponent, a Mighty Whip Dagger is made with especially heavy material that allows a strong user to take advantage of an above-average strength score. The Mighty Whipdagger allows you to add your strength bonus to damage up to the maximum bonus indicated. Table 1-5. Mighty Whips and Whip Daggers. Item, Whip, Mighty 1. +1 strength bonus. Cost 200 gold pieces. Damage 1 die, 2. 2. Crit. +2. Range 15 feet. 1. Weight 3 pounds. Type slashing. Item. Whip Mighty 1. +2 strength bonus. Cost 300 gold pieces. Damage 1 die. 2. 2. Crit. +2. Range 15 feet. 1. Weight 4 pounds. Type slashing. Item. Whip Mighty 1. +3 strength bonus. Cost 400 gold pieces. Damage 1 die. 2. 2. Crit. +2. Range 15 feet. 1. Weight 5 pounds. Type slashing. Item. Whip Mighty 1. +4 strength bonus. Cost 500 gold pieces. Damage 1 die. 2. 2. Crit. +2. 15. Range 15 feet. 1. Weight 6 pounds. Type slashing. Item. Whip Dagger Mighty, +1 strength bonus, cost 225 gold pieces, damage 1 die 6, crit +2, range 15 feet 1, weight 4 pounds, type slashing. Item, Whip Dagger Mighty, +2 strength bonus, cost 325 gold pieces, damage 1 die 6, crit +2, range 15 feet 1, weight 5 pounds, type slashing. Item, Whip Dagger Mighty, +3 strength bonus, cost 425 gold pieces. Damage 1 die 6, crit +2, range 15 feet 1, weight 6 pounds, type slashing. Item, Whip Dagger Mighty, +4 strength bonus, cost 525 gold pieces, damage 1 die 6, crit +2, range 15 feet 1, weight 7 pounds, type slashing. 1. See weapon entry for special